Hello and very good morning one and all. Now we are going to study next point on impingement rate, which is in the course of our experimental techniques in physics. First of all, for that impingement rate, which is denoted by symbol Z suffix A and having unit per centimeter square per second. So per centimeter square is the unit of per area and per second is the unit of per unit time. So in very rough words, I can say impingement rate is defined as number of molecules of a particular gas which are colliding on a wall per unit area per unit time. Now, for this, we need monolayer formation time. So that is denoted by symbol tau. Monolayer formation time and impingement rate are very closely related. So monolayer formation time tau is denoted by symbol tau and measured in seconds. First of all, we are going to see what is mean by monolayer formation time, a technique which is frequently used to characterize pressure state in high vacuum region is the calculation of time required to form monolayer. Now, this monoatomic layer on a gas-free surface is defined as is under the assumption that every molecule will stick on the surface, and the time required to form that monolayer on the surface is monolayer formation time. Now, this time is closely related to impingement rate. Now, definition of impingement rate is this, which is given over here. So, impingement rate will indicate number of molecules which collide with the surface inside the vacuum vessel per unit time and per unit surface area. So ZA is the impingement rate, which is defined as ZA is equal to N into average C bar divided by 4. Now, if A is the number of spaces per unit surface area for sticking molecules which can accept a specific gas, then monolayer formation time is defined as tau is equal to A divided by ZA. So this is the relation which is between tau and ZA. If you take this ZA on the left-hand side and tau on right-hand side, so ZA, that is impingement rate, is equal to A divided by tau. So this is the relation. Now, we are going to study next property of gases, which is conductance. So conductance of a gas is measured in liter per second. So in rough words, again, we know that volume of a gas is measured in liter and per second is the unit of time. So conductance is nothing but amount of gas flowing per unit time. Now, in another words, let PV is the flow through any desired piping element. That piping element may be pipe or hose or valves, nozzles, or opening of the wall between two vessels. Now, this QV is defined as QPV is equal to C, capital C, which is conductance into P1 minus P2. Now, P1 minus P2 here is replaced by delta P symbol. So, in other words, QPV is equal to P delta P into C. Here, delta P is the difference between pressure at inlet and outlet ends of the piping element. This factor, which is constant, is known as conductance of that particular element. Now, one more important thing about conductance, it depends on geometry of the piping element and can be calculated for simple configurations. So, here we will see calculations in the next lectures. Okay, in the forthcoming lecture, we will see how to calculate those conductance. In the high and ultra high vacuum range, C is constant, that is conductance is constant, and that is independent of pressure. And in rough and medium high region of vacuums, it is depend on pressure. So this is also very important part about conductance. Now, as a consequence, calculation of C for piping element must be carried out separately for individual pressure ranges. Now, from definition of volumetric flow, it is also possible to state that the conductance of a flow can be stated by using Ohm's law for vacuum technology. Now, this is Ohm's law for vacuum technology. Is this R is equal to 1 upon C, where R is also known as impedance. Okay. So if you have asked what is mean by impedance, then simple definition of impedance is it is reciprocal of conductance. So unit of impedance is opposite to that of conductance. Now we know that unit of conductance is liter per second. So unit of impedance is second per liter. Now it has been introduced as reciprocal value of conductance wall. That equation can be rewritten. QPV is equal to 1 over R, that is impedance, into delta P. Now we can use, if we connected very large number of elements of like for example pipe or other elements, then their impedance is given by this equation. Re is the equivalent impedance, which is R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now this is like for resistance in series. Okay, so similar equation applied for if we connect very large number of elements, piping elements in vacuum, then their resultant impedance is addition of individual components. Now similarly for parallel combination, this relation is useful. So this is also for, we know the case for if we connect more than one resistance in parallel. Next important part is pumping speed. Next point, pumping speed S. Now this pumping speed is measured in liter per second or meter cube per hour or centimeter cube per second. Now as a rough definition, you know the definition of pumping speed. Liter is the unit of volume, so amount of volume, amount of any given gas passing per second. The pumping speed is the volumetric flow through the pump's intake port. Now this S, pumping speed, is given by dV upon dt, where dV is the difference in volume and S is the time. S is the pumping speed, dV is change in volume, dT is change in time. If S is remain constant during the pumping process, then one can use the difference quotient instead of differential quotient. So S is delta V upon delta T. Next point, we are going to study types of flow. So as you already studied in case of fluid mechanics, there are two major type of flow. First is turbulent flow and second one is viscous or continuous flow. Now in vacuum technology, why this type of flow is important? Because when we are making vacuum, means we are taking out gases from that system, from that vacuum chamber, so gas is flowing. So that's why initially the number of gas molecules is very large, so flow is turbulent flow. And as we take out gas, more and more amount of gas is taking out from the system, so those number is reducing very drastically, so that flow will become then this continuous flow. In this types of flow we will be seeing, this flow is found almost exclusively in the rough vacuum ranges, The characteristics of this type of flow is determined by interaction of molecules. For example, the interaction includes internal friction, viscosity of following substance is the major factor. If vortex motion appears in the streaming process, one speaks of turbulent flow. Vortex motion means like this type of motion, which is zigzag. So you can see that vortex motion in very large, if the molecules are very large. If various layers of following medium slide one over the other, then the term laminar flow or layer flux must be applied. Laminar flow or circular tubes with parabolic velocity distribution is known as Pioselli's flow. This special case is found frequently in vacuum technology, because in vacuum technology we are having circular tubes, which is having circular cross section. The viscous flow will generally found where molecules having mean free path considerably shorter than diameter of the pipe. So this is the important point, when that viscous flow will appear. When mean free path, that is lambda, we know how to find out lambda, is shorter than diameter, means lambda is less than d. Here symbol is less than. When lambda is less than d, then we get viscous flow. The characteristic quantity describing viscous flow state is the dimensionless Reynolds number. So you already know Reynolds number and its significance. If Reynolds number is product of pipe diameter, flow velocity, density and reciprocal value of viscosity, internal friction of the gas. So you know the formula for Reynolds number, R is equal to, okay, so it is rho eta divided by d. Now this formula you can take from any book. I will suggest FYBAC physics book, you will have this formula for Reynolds number. Now if this Reynolds number, if flow is turbulent flow, in that case Reynolds number is greater than 2200, and laminar flow when Reynolds number is less than 2200. The phenomenon of choked flow may be observed in the viscous flow situation. It plays a part when venting and evacuating a pump vessel and where there are leaks. So gas will always flow where there is a difference in pressure. So if this is the basic condition for flowing of gas, so we know that there must be pressure difference. So P1 minus P2, which is delta P, is greater than the intensity of gas flow, that is quantity of gas flowing over the period of time, rises with pressure differential. In the case of viscous flow, this will be the case only until flow velocity. Now, critical pressure, certain pressure difference, critical. Now, this critical pressure can be found out by this equation. Now, this is very important for distinguishing between the different fluids. Here, molecular flow. Here this graph shows that venting time and pressure change. So here delta P is like this. Now molecular flow. Molecular flow prevails in the high and ultra-high vacuum ranges, because in high and ultra-high vacuum range, the number of molecules which are present in the system are very less. In these regions, molecules can move freely without any mutual interference. Molecular flow is present where the mean free path length for a particle is very much longer than diameter of the pipe. So this is the condition. Remember, lambda is mean free path is very, very greater than d. Now, for previous case, we know that lambda is less than d, where d is the diameter. The next, Knudsen flow. The transitional range between viscous flow and molecular flow is also known as Knudsen flow. It is in case of when lambda, which is mean free path, is compared to d. The product of pressure p and pipe diameter d for a particular gas certain temperature can serve as a characteristic quantity for various types of flow. Now here we can see this. From this you can see various flow regions. There are three major flow regions. First one is viscous flow, second one is Knudsen flow, and third one is molecular flow. So all these depends on lambda. Okay, so lambda is mean free path. If lambda is less than d divided by 100, then we have rough vacuum. Then path difference is greater than, sorry, pressure difference, here Pd is pressure difference, is greater than 6 × 10⁻¹ millibar centimeter. Then next, medium vacuum. In case of medium vacuum, we are having Knudsen flow. So path this lambda, which is mean free path, is greater than d divided by 100 but less than d by 2. Then we have this Pd 6, where P is pressure and d is diameter, so product of Pd. So Pd having value 6 × 10⁻¹ to 1.3 × 10⁻²⁻² millibar centimeter. For ultra high and high vacuum regions, this mean free path lambda is greater than d by 2, so product of pressure and diameter is greater than 1.3 × 10⁻²⁻² millibar centimeter. So this is very important. Okay, just you have to recall it. Okay, because from this you can write various ranges of pressure. Again, here I have given some explanation about how, on which factors that depends. Here this range of pressure is also given. So now next we are moving to another important part, is calculating conductance values. So I already told you what is mean by conductance. So definition of conductance for a gas which is flowing in the pipe is given. Now calculation. Effective pumping speed required to evacuate a vessel or to carry out process inside a vacuum system will correspond to the inlet speed of a particular pump or pump system. If pump is joined directly to the vessel or system, this is possible only in rare situations. It is almost necessary to include intermediate piping system comprising valves, separators, cool traps, and like. Now, if the corresponding to that effective pumping speed, which is S effective, is always less than pumping speed S of the pump. So, effective pumping speed at vacuum vessel, it is necessary to select a pump with greater pumping speed. Okay, so this is very important. Greater pumping speed is required. The correlation between S and S effective is indicated by following basic equation. So S effective is 1 upon S plus 1 upon C. So here C is total conductance of a total of valves, okay, which are present for the piping system made up of the individual valves of the components connected in series, valves, baffles, separators, etc. So equation is this, 1 upon C. Here 1 upon C is found out by this equation. Okay, so this is the effective conductance of all the vacuum systems. Suppose this is vacuum system and here this is piping, and here we have various elements. Okay, so this is conductance of all this system. Is suppose conductance of this is C1, conductance of this is C2, and conductance of this is C3. So these are connected in series. So 1 upon C is the effective conductance, which is given as 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3 to 1 upon C1. it should be noted that in general that the conductance in a vacuum component is not a constant value which is independent of prevailing vacuum levels, but rather depends strongly on nature of the flow. What type of flow we are talking about, that is continuous flow, molecular flow, and thus on pressure. When using conductance indices in vacuum technology calculations, is always necessary to pay attention to the fact that only the conductance valves applicable to a certain pressure regimes may be applied in that region. Now, conductance for piping and orifices. So, orifices means the orifices means the rings which are like this. You will find out on internet what is the orifices correspond. The conductance valves will depend not only on pressure and the nature of the gas which is flowing, but also on the sectional shape of the conducting elements. Now, that sectional shape includes, it is either circular, elliptical, cross section. Other factors are length and whether the element is spread or curved. The result is that various equations are required to take into account practical situations. Each of these equations is valid only for particular pressure range. This is always to be considered in calculations. Now for this part, conductance for a straight pipe. So if pipe is straight, okay, like this, which is not too short of length L, with a circular cross section of diameter D, laminar Knudsen and molecular flow regions valid only at 20 degrees Celsius, which is Knudsen equation. So C is given as 135, this is the equation, D raised to 4 divided by I P bar plus 12.1 D cube divided by I into 1 plus 192 D P bar 1 plus 237 D P bar divided by P bar. So L liter per second, so this is the unit liter per second, where P bar is P1 plus P2 divided by 2, D is pipe inside diameter in centimeter, L is pipe length, here L, this L is length of pipe in centimeter, which should be greater than 10 times D. P1 is the pressure at the start of the pipe, which is pressure over here, and P2 is pressure at the end of the pipe. If one rewrite the second term in that equation, then C is 12.1 D cube divided by L into F, with F D P bar is given by this equation. Now it is possible to derive two important limits for the course of F, limit for laminar flow. In this equation for laminar flow, P bar is greater than D into P bar, where diameter and P bar having product 6 into 10 raised to minus 1 millibar centimeter, then C is given by, this equation is given by C is equal to 135 D raised to 4 divided by L into P bar in liter per second. And for molecular flow, D into P bar is less than equal to 10 raised to minus 2 millibar. This limit is very important. So C is 12.1 D cube divided by I in liter per second. So here you can see the equations are very complicated, and how we use those equations is also depend on practical situations. Okay. So what are the practical situation is present, depending on that we can get equation. So with this I think we should end our lecture over here. We will see remaining part in the next lectures. Thank